Hey everyone, Gabriel Nassif for ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be playing Pioneer. I'm going to be playing Niv again, except this time I'm going to be playing the 60 card version, no Yorion. This is the list I played in the Pioneer Championship last weekend. I qualified playing an 80 card version, but after playing some more, the 80 card version was a bit inconsistent. And having turn two card is really important. I played some with the 60 card. I like the deck better. I like the deck better against a mono green planeswalker, for instance. You just need that extra consistency. You get better opening hands. You also just get, you know, better draw steps. I really felt a difference in variance. I guess a little more variance on your draws. So. Yeah, I decided to play that. I was qualified. LSV was qualified too. LSV played his John Citadel deck. We both didn't do very well. It was a small tournament. I was 24 players, so I went 3-2 into the top 8. Luis was 2-2. He needed to win his last one to maybe make top 8. My breakers were pretty good. His were not as good, but yeah, I lost. I lost in the quarters to combo. I lost. To the same person twice, actually. We're playing basically Underworld Breach without Underworld Breach. It's Lotus Field deck that just uses double cast and more dig for times to make up for the fact they don't have Underworld Breach. And deck is still pretty good. It's good against Niv. I came prepared. I thought I came prepared, but it wasn't enough. I definitely misplayed that matchup a bunch. I was a bit disappointed. The winner of the tournament got to qualify for the Magic Online Championship. So, yeah, my record wasn't great, but I was pretty confident with the list going on, and I still really like the list. Nothing too crazy. Couple push mains, couple like non-gold cards main, the push, the Thoughtseize, the traverse. Maybe the most surprising thing is that I'm only playing three Nivs and only playing three Bring to Light. It was something I was already doing in the past. I used to have four Bring to Light, three Niv. I've had the one traverse over Niv number four be pretty strong for me. Lets you play one less land. It was especially good in just a little extra consistency basically. So yeah, obviously lots of different cards in the deck. You're playing Niv, but I'll go through them real quick. I also really like the mana base. I think I've been working on the mana base a lot and tweaked it a bunch, and I think it's pretty solid. So yeah, carried it, your two-drop all-star, couple drip boars, and abrupt decay. You could play more of these cards if push wasn't so important, but I think having four push in the 75 between the main and the sideboard is really important for a ton of matchups. And yeah, I've got more one drops. Deathrite Shaman, it's a hit on Niv. It's one of the best cards in the mirror or against Sultai. It's cheap. It deals with Ura well. The big downside, obviously, is you have a prime target for Fatal Push, so that part's not great. But even against the black deck, if it goes unanswered, it can be really strong. One Traverse, free Teferi, free Ura, just curve things. Some versions play four Teferi. I think the card is good, but not amazing. Apparently, there is Teamer Reclamation starting to show up. It won the latest, one of the latest Pioneer Challenge. So that could be a reason to go back to Fort Ferry. I actually haven't played this matchup yet. And I'm not really sure what to expect. I'm guessing it's pretty tough. So we'll see. Oath of Kaya, card I've always liked. Good target for Teferi. It's showing respect to the black aggro decks and the red aggro decks. And it's never totally dead, you know, you can finish off Planeswalkers, etc. Other end, just kind of necessary evil. Slaughter Games is one of the more questionable main deck cards, but I like it. Two Nahiri, just solid enchantment removal filter. It's kind of an engine. It's nice that it dodges stuff like Mystical Dispute and Mausoleum Wanderer too. Non-blue high impact cards are kind of nice in some matchups, especially after sideboard. Nicobolas, you can't get it of Niv, but I think it's good enough for the curve. The body is solid in the format. It's just pretty well positioned, which is not always the case with a card like Nicobolas, but I think it's nice in the format. And then I've got Hour of Devastation. I think this card is pretty much mandatory. Just good sweeper in the format, decent against Green Planeswalker, gets around Selfless Spirit, and Falsimir, I think this is the best target against most of the aggro decks. Even against Mono Black, it's sometimes better than Blood Baron of Viscopa. I've been in many, many spots where even if I had Blood Baron, I would still get Tulsimir. Yeah, it's just like card I like a bit better overall. Blood Baron is kind of nice in the mirror match, actually. It's kind of hard to deal with, so Niv is pretty popular right now, so it's not the worst card, but I like the Tulsimir still for now. Against a deck like Spirits too, but if the meta shifts a bit, maybe you can switch it up. Sideboard, bunch of like non-gold all-stars, Dispute and Push, and then some cards to shore up the different matchups. Is it Guild being represented? Is it Static Caster? You could play Gruul Charm if you're if you really want to play at least one of each gold color combination. Gruul Charm is red and green, instant speed, free damage to all flyers, so that could be good, but yeah. A little extra spot removal, a second Slaughter Games. Lavinia's most exclusively for the Breach matchup, since they rely on Lotus Field plus Thespian Stage. It can stop them from casting Dig Three Times and Poor Verdant Pages, etc. Second Oath of Kaya, I've actually struggled a bit against the red decks. The black matchup's pretty good, but you can use the help. You know, it's just a really strong card, combination with Nahiri and stuff against the aggro decks. So, yeah, I guess Silumgar Command is for the Mono Green Planeswalker. It's the only card that kills an Issa Planeswalker and gives you extra value, so that's why I like this card. Yeah, so that's it for the deck. Okay, so if you noticed, I got a haircut, just got a haircut today. Had been 6 months. So yeah, I'm gonna hop into the action, hop into a league. I haven't played a ton of Pioneer. I played that tournament and I played a bit the week leading to the tournament, but I played against, I tried to do a bit more serious testing. I played a set of matches against my podcast co-host, Harry MTG. He was playing the Mono Green Planeswalkers, and it went pretty well for me. I also played a bit against Traft, actually, who's in the trophy leaderboard. He was playing Spirits, so got to practice that matchup. Galalicious, I think he's playing, I actually played against him in one of my last leagues. He's playing I think he should be playing the combo deck. This hand is not super great against the combo deck, but I do have turn 5 Niv, maybe turn 4 Niv if I get a little lucky into potentially, I'm gonna keep because I'm not 100% sure he's playing combo, but I think he's playing the combo deck. It's kind of a disaster if I mulligan this hand and he's not playing the combo deck. All right, I'm glad I didn't just go all in on the read there. That in pretty brutal to mulligan a great hand against a red deck. I'm gonna go ahead and use the push right away, even just for the one damage, since it's one of their creatures that doesn't die to Solar Blaze. Beyond the plan, curving out as a fatal push should be just good enough to win game one. You know, crash reaction. Is it the one that gives haste? Target creature gives haste in end of turn. Alright. Little mute button check. Light it up again. Alright. When I saw Crash, I was wondering if maybe they were playing a blue version. Alright, well. Obviously, this Solar Blade is not looking the greatest. I like this card a lot. I get the Supreme Verdict question a lot. Supreme Verdict's extremely hard to cast in this deck. Well, extremely, you know, as far as casting cards go, it's really up there. Hard to cast double white and blue. Also, killing your card is a really big deal. I just feel like Solar Blaze, honestly. It's one of the best cards against Mono Green Planeswalkers, which is arguably the best deck in Pioneer. Doomwake, who's... the Doomwake who beat me in the final of the qualifier when I qualified. He went 12-0, and then he actually won the actual Pioneer Championship, the 24 player tournament one. Sorry. Yeah, so he's been crushing with Mono Green Planeswalker. I think it's the consensus best deck for now, but I think I like my matchup, and I think Solar Blaze is a big part of it. I even have the second one in the sideboard. All right. This is kind of scary. Still had a fairly healthy life total, but... it's nice I didn't get to take any... didn't have to take any paint from my lands either. Let's see. So, I guess I should fetch. Since I already have a land drop for next turn, I want to just maximize my odds of hitting spells with Niv. All right, pretty solid. So next turn, 6 mana, I can just play, I could even play triple spell maybe if I have the right mana. Green, 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 red, black, yeah. We'll see. I don't think I'm in too much danger. All right, pretty good tempo play for them. I'm at 8. Don't think they can really burn me out. I'm probably gonna go with the removal carried line here. What else would I do? Definitely don't want to play Niv. Nahiri plus Abrupt Decay. That's a bit worse. Red, black. And I don't think there's a point in playing Abrupt Decay on my turn. I guess they do know about the Abrupt Decay. Not a big surprise. I'm not gonna trick them. I guess that's a reason to not do it on my turn. I was gonna block here. I mean, they only have one card in hand. Even if it's somehow a pump spell and I lose my carry, it's not a big deal. No reason to take a single point of damage here. Still at 8. Bring to life for Uro, I can just snare, I think. Probably fine. Rest of Kaya, perfect. Alright, couple push in. Dispute could be good. Oath of Kaya is definitely good. Dreadmoor and Decay could be okay. Solar Blaze. I don't think it's the worst, but we'll see. Alright, don't want Thassies. Don't want Teferi. Don't want Slaughter Games. Outer End's a bit expensive. Hour of Devastation is probably not necessary. This looks pretty reasonable. They might have their own disputes. Maybe Teferi's a bit better than having three Bring to Lights and three Nivs. I could see that. All right, I'm gonna do that. See how that goes. Another really good hand. And they don't even have the one drop. Alright, so hand's a bit weak to entity. I'm not sure if there's a way to put entity into play on turn two in Pioneer. Alright, so I can push right away and play a tap land and then play Uro next turn. I might do that honestly because Carried doesn't really accelerate me into anything right now. Given my hands. So I think I kind of like just saving the damage here. All right, I'm just gonna go ahead and Uro. They might have dispute though. Yeah, maybe that wasn't the greatest. Dispute is gonna be good against me most likely though. I think in hindsight, I wish I'd played Carried in Triome. Well, definitely in hindsight, but even, I think it's just a better line. All right, let's see. They don't have much going on, so I'm just gonna make sure I don't take too much damage for no reason. Oh, that was a disaster. Thought I was being smart by playing on their turn, making use mana on their turn. Yikes. see what they did with this cry. On top, on bottom. So I can decay plus carroted, or I can Nicol Bolas and get one of their two cards. Probably need to decay plus carroted if I have the mana, which I do. Yeah, I let them use their mana so efficiently this game. I guess I should keep the game log up. They bottomed. Wow, right, Treasure Cruise. That's a card. Alright, I'm just gonna play Ravager and hope they don't have another dispute. Unfortunate. I wonder if I could have won this game with better sequencing. Lucky, or even if I have gust or something. It's not necessarily good for me that they didn't have burn spells. I just mean they have more. I also was hoping maybe they killed it. Maybe that would have made the play, let it die. Kept one on top again. Yikes. All right, I need to draw like a Fabled Passage. Wait, no, I need to draw any untapped land or cheese spell. That's pretty good too. Ooh. I see if they have any instant, I lose, but I think if they have any instant, I'm in bad shape either way, so probably should just play Tulsimir. Also better if they have dispute somehow. They have a third dispute. All right. Get to live at least one more turn. So why did you top a Treasure Cruise? Light up the stage. It's pretty good too. Our deck is nice. You still get to play. Pioneer has these cards that are bans in them in some formats, but you still get to play Treasure Cruise, Dig Through Time, Teferi Time Raveler. Shock. I'm guessing they don't have a ton of shocks left up for sideboard. Top. Not great. That's not great either. Let's see. Green. Green. Blue, like that, is fine. All right. Too many caryatids. All right, I'm assuming I'm very dead, but... in play. All right. Don more answers to the entity. Let's see. Starblaze would have been better than NNT this game. Deal with the problem creatures. Maybe four fatal push and two abrupt decays, too many. They have the 8 one drop prowess guys and the 4 scrites, probably. That's 12. I could see one igniv maybe. I need to really run out of gas this game. Maybe I don't need Talsimir in this matchup. It's not the greatest. Maybe Niv's just better. The life gain is nice though. Let's see. I could see cutting a number of DK on the play and doing an extra nav. Hopefully that's not too greedy. Plus I brought in the second Solar Blaze. Definitely missed the second Solar Blaze this game. My abrupt DK or... Bit of a slow hand. But I think it's good enough. I don't think you can mulligan this. So it gives me the best shot at playing Dreadbore turn two. They're both the same. It's just better in the long run. Turn three Dreadbore into four, turn four Nicobolas into turn five Bring to Light is like... Hopefully good enough. Alright, I can Dreadborn now. But is that really my prime dreadboard target? Stop slide up the stage. But I usually don't want to play light up the stage on two. Probably if I play Crag now. Yeah, I guess that's not great, because if I play Crag now to traverse, I still have to shock myself. Alright. Yeah, definitely not an ideal start for me. Still no white mana. Yeah, I don't love my chances this game. Maybe it's just bad play to use Dreadbore on their one drop. Maybe Sprite Dragon, etc. are just way too scary. Looks like Galish has just got my number no matter what they're playing. Combo, aggro. It's like so bad for me to play spells here. It just makes the Sprite Dragon bigger, lets them use their card efficiently, but blue black, I don't think I have a choice, honestly. I think I just have to hope they run out. I don't think they're gonna run out. I think that Sprite Dragon's just gonna go all the way, but I think that's just what I have to do, honestly. Haven't really been able to buy a win in these past few videos for Channel Fireball. I mean, just bottom. I guess it shows that, you know, everyone goes, it's not all wins all the time. Yeah, I just don't know why Dreadboard that Salt Scar Mage, honestly. Sprite Dragon's just so terrifying. I feel bad. Oh well, making mistakes so you don't have to, right? I don't even have a good target for Bring to Light, honestly. Green, black, red, blue, white. Got four cards in hand. I mean, it's probably getting countered. What should I get? Just black, green. I think I should get black in case I don't fatal push next turn. I mean, these kind of fish decks are kind of tough matchups. Game one's probably decent for me, and then sideboard when they get Dispute and Gust. Even Stubborn Denial gets really bad. They have Ramnap Runes in play too. Treasure Cruise, yeah. I mean, I feel a bit bad about my play, but it also just seems like a really tough matchup. That looks sweet. I wonder if it's... because it's not something that's really been around in Pioneer. It's one of the best decks in Modern. Or maybe the best deck in Modern, just Blue-Red Prowess, so it makes sense. Alright. So... yeah, amazing that Dreadblore was. Was bad. I mean, to be fair, to say I had like six or seven cards in hand, I think I would have lost anyways. A slightly different sideboarding would have made a difference in game two. But it's hard to know when you're gonna need the cheap spot removal and when you're gonna need the sweeper. One day I'll do well for a Channel Fireball video. I promise. This way I had to play against kind of a new deck. Haven't really seen that. I wonder if it was a list from a challenge, maybe? From a recent challenge, or something that's just been around a bit in leagues and stuff. Because, let's see, Pioneer Preliminary. Last Pioneer Prelim had a Team of Reclamation deck that 5-0'd. Any Entity decks? Nope. No blue-white prowess in the last few big Pioneer lists or Pioneer results. So, still thinking about that match, things I could have done a bit differently. The trophy leaders, I don't know how much they play, but Claudia H is just pretty much only plays 5-color Niv. I think he got pretty much all his trophies with 5-color Niv. He's, you know, he goes back and forth between like kind of a stockish list, and he also tries stuff sometimes. The other day he 5-0'd a league was a bunch of spell colors, Teferi and Sea Drinos. I'm not even sure he had Brain Flight in his list. So, and Japanese Fisherman is also a 5-color Niv player. He likes the 80-card version. I'm not a big fan of the Japanese Fisherman list usually. I think the 60 card version is better, and some of his card choices I'm not a big fan of, but yeah, not a pretty great hand. The way I build the mana base, my check lands like Glacial Fortress, etc., they all have, I think, 11 lands that makes them come into play untapped. I think not counting basics and Fabled Passage. And it's the reason why I play Steam Vents and not Sulfur Fold, because Sulfur Fold would come into play tapped a bit more often. All right. So they're on the play. They have the kind of anti-Solar Blaze ram draw. So it might not be as good as usual. My hand's somewhat up the nuts. I mean, Fatal Passage doesn't come into play on tap, so that could cost me the game. But I mean, that's kind of what you want to see in this matchup. Carried it onto and Solar Blaze. All right, they don't have Nykthos. Actually should have probably not played their land before playing Oath, unless they have like definitely no intention of taking Nykthos. I guess you never know when you're just gonna have like two Forests and a Nykthos on top. If they don't have Karn, I might be okay even if I can't Solar Blaze next turn. If they just have Nissa or Vivian, I think these cards are beatable. I'll lose the green matchup too, and people watching are going to be like, well, sure, Gab, your deck beats green, your deck's the best deck in the format. Sure thing. Deep in the tank, took a Vivian. The token part and the fighting part's not scary. The -5 get a creature could be. Alright, okay, Solar Blaze doesn't do much. I'm just gonna go ahead and Teferi bounce the elf. Try and find something good. Instant Speed Solar Blaze next turn could be good. Alright, they do have Nykthos. Man, they might have Ulamog mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Wow. They're one short of Ulamog. Never mind. That's Ulamog. Jesus Christ. Well, that's probably GG. Nissa first. Yes. You should have Ulamog in their sideboard. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and I think I can scoop Dev out, have an other end. I guess I'm not technically dead. Probably just go after two lands here. Yep. Yeah, I mean I have another end. I can actually like bring to light to into other end. I'm gonna have the mana in two turns. Could technically still win this game. Fetch first so I don't get wrecked by just not having a basic left in my deck. Alright, did he get other end or not? Did he get other end and do I have another out? Alright, we're alive. We're still alive. Big Hydra. Even Big Hydra, we're still alive. I have push plus mana for Outer End. Means no more Bring to Light, though. Indestructible. I guess I'll play it out. I don't think I can win with 7 cards left in my deck, but you never know. Alright, that's probably good enough. Is it just in case? Alright, so push comes in, Silumgar's command comes in. Static caster, I'm not sure what I usually do. On the play might be okay. Solar Blaze, which was did nothing this game, comes in. You want all the cheap removal. I usually just board out Teferi. Let's see, we'll see what these free mana cards do. Teferi. Slaughter Games goes out. I think I like Anahiri. I think I keep in Nicobolas. And I usually board out a Niv. Do I keep in Nicobolas in this matchup? I think it's alright. Static caster, turn 3, kill your elf, kill your other elves and block. I think I bring it in. I think something like this is all right. I like Thassi's in this matchup too, but I think Tide Erasure is just a tiny bit too expensive. Alright, this hand is fine. Doesn't have the big payoffs, but should be good enough. I guess I need to get green, black, black, black. Yeah, I need to get white on turn one. Blue or red on turn one. So I can actually cast Niv on curve. Could argue for red because of Aura of Devastation. In case I draw it. Might be better than blue. Blue's for Uro. Alright, Solar Blaze that I cannot cast, cool. Alright, change of plans, I guess. So the Oath into Nykthos, they have 6 mana. Which is not too scary, I guess. Three, four, six. Play Nissa, one left on tap Nykthos. Okay, they can't go too crazy. All right, Vivian. Alright, I'm glad that you sum up the thing I say ends up being kind of true. You don't feel like I'm just making stuff up. So they have Vivian in hand, so playing Nicobola is not super great right now. I'm gonna play Uro and probably just keep mana up for other end. You just dreadboard that now. That's gonna say go, he just fits the curve better. I'll other end Vivian probably. On tap, dreadboard plus Ravager. Well, for a Dreadboard kill Planeswalker too. Awkward. So what's up, chat? What's up, viewers? Crisp. To be fair, technical gameplay was never my my strong suit. It kind of worked out. I drew Fatal Push. Calculated, right? That's what they say. No need to push right away in case exactly this happens. They might like try and fight or something. All right, I don't think they're coming back from this spot either. I can flip Nicobe next turn. All right, that one a bit better. Do I want Neko Bolas on the draw? That seems kind of underwhelming, actually. I'm gonna go with Nev. Bit heavy on the five, definitely. I could see just having any of the three or four mana cards, honestly, over another five. I'm not 100% sure you need Tall Simmer in this matchup. I'll do a Oath of Gaia. I don't hate it. It kills creatures, it also kills Karn minus. Oh, I should have boarded out Staticast around the draw. Yikes. Loose plays. Turn to Abrupt Decay, turn for Oath of Gaia. I have everything but blue. Think I have to keep. Don't want to shock myself to get the blue mana now. How is it going to work out in the curve? If I don't, I go Temple Garden into Abrupt Decay, into Oath of Gaia, into Traverse Uro. Alright, I'm going to be a bit greedy here and try and save the 2 damage. It could be relevant. Not a pretty scary draw, for sure. Actually, don't ask why I didn't kill the wolf while I'm making so many mistakes. I just tunnel vision. I should have gone for the wolf Willowhaven. Wow, what a terrible mistake. I don't have a good target for Oath of Gaia. I got Oath of Gaia to Vivian. Keep it in check. Alright, that worked out. Alright, a question is... So I'm gonna have instant creature. Am I gonna need to land this game? I'm gonna ever gonna be able to trigger a. Maybe I should just Earth of Kaya this turn and take another hit. I don't hate it. Earth of Kaya the Vivian. Yeah. Not ideal. I think we lost. They can just get the 6 mana artifact and play it next turn, and that card's almost impossible to beat. Oh, they got Stonecold Serpent, but they can get it next turn. Man, all my plays kind of backfiring. 1/1 Serpent. Okay. Yeah. Rough. Rough stuff. Because I didn't traverse on turn one, I call it Uro plus Fatal Push. I don't think that would really save me, to be honest, but. Alright, well. They could just not have, and I guess technically they don't have the mana to play the artifact. So they don't have 6 mana, they can get like a Gear Hulk. Sky Sovereign. That shoots planeswalkers. I'm hanging in there. Let's see, do I push now? Push now, hope their hand is absolutely terrible, but I already know they don't have lands. All right, well, stuff happens, right? I still think the matchup is like pretty decent. I think it's favorable for Niv. Obviously, this is a loss, but I think my draws were like kind of not the greatest, and they had, you know, I mean, it is still like the best deck or one of the best decks in the format, this green deck, and when they have their like turn one elf, when they keep 7, they have turn one elf. And, you know, planes, good mix of planeswalkers, lands, and spell. They're still probably, you know, they can still win. I mean, like, I feel like my draw was, like, not great, and I still kind of hung in there. But yeah, RSC doesn't feel great to lose this matchup. All right, let's see. So I need to Uro first. What's better, Uro or Uro Starblaze? I guess either way, I don't really need black mana. Oh, that doesn't work. All right. All right, GG's. I think my keep was okay, like super borderline though. I think it's definitely, I wouldn't keep much worse than that. The fact that I didn't have the blue mana yet and like the removal I had was, like, not the greatest. I think in some of their like less explosive draws, the hand can be good enough, but maybe it was a mulligan. Because it is really about like kind of goldfishing a bit, and it's not like they have too much disruption and removal, that kind of stuff. So it's possible it was just like not the greatest keep. All right, this is kind of a random hand with a bunch of silver bullets. So who knows? I mean, it seems like either one of them should be good depending on the matchup. I'm going to go ahead and keep. It's always the same thing in matchups where you're kind of goldfishing and your opponent's not interacting too much with you with cards like discard spells or removal, you can mulligan a bit more aggressively. And alright, did I get to redeem myself or bury myself a bit deeper here? And go ahead and just play Triumph on turn one. The Fright's not doing too much in this matchup besides Strum blocking. Or blocking in this case, I guess. Well, that was a absolutely great draw. Going with Fabled Passage now, because the land comes into play tapped. I need to land in the graveyard. I can probably play Solder Blaze next turn. It's kind of the biggest downside with Fabled Passage. I mean, it always is, right? But it's awkward in the curve because you can't always play turn one, and then a lot of time you only play carried it on two, and then if you play it on three, it's your fourth mana, but it doesn't come into play untapped. I need to get, sweet in the pot. I like it. Doesn't really matter what I get, I guess. Maybe get red still. Zabdower Abdev. Alright, does that come into play on tap? Glacial Fortress, Triumph, yes. Make, doesn't matter. See, I have potentially six mana. Can bust out another Planeswalker. Oh, it's super nice. I got a forest in the yard too. I didn't even think about that. It's kind of sick. Can I actually fight? I'm not sure they're going to want to do that though. They're probably going to want to put counters. I don't know. I guess, no, I guess they probably should fight because I could cast a Niv next turn. I think that's probably a mistake they just made. That's pretty greedy. It's definitely a matchup that gets tougher when the green player does everything right. You definitely notice the difference. All right, I should hour now. Don't wanna pay two now or one. Probably was Nahiri in hand. I just want to go ahead and shock myself. I mean, I guess I still lose if they just have a land next turn. Oh, they're just casting Karn. Is that even better than just attacking? I guess they have Citadel in their deck. Yeah. Could backfire though. I can Nahiri minus. Gonna buy me a bit of time. I'm just gonna go ahead and play a fetch land. Slaughter Games main deck is kind of rough in a fairly fast meta between mono green walkers and spirits, mono black, etc. But I felt like it was worth it. I feel like there's enough Niv, control, Jeskai Luka combo. What did he get this time? Pithing Needle? Alright, I mean, why not? It's more damage to my face, I guess. So I have black, red, blue, white. I can just get blue or green, basically. Yeah, that's fair. This way they have lethal next turn if they draw a land. Traverse was free cards in my yard. It's actually nuts that the fact they didn't kill Nahiri means my Traverse is not a... It's like all my choices being wrong here, the Traverse over the Niv. It's usually good. It's usually really good. The one Traverse, I've been a big fan. It's looking pretty bad here. Let's see. Do I want to Traverse now or not? All right, no land. Gains haste to right. No. Oh, that looks like no land. I think we only have like 21, 22 lands. Let's see. Oh, it's non-land. Right. Right, right, right. So I can Utterend Nissa? No, I don't even have the mana. I was going to say Utterend Nissa, Traverse for Caryatid. But I'm one short, right? All right. Gonna go ahead and play my own variants. The different shaman was kind of the nuts. I like that card in small number. Let's see, I think this is what I want to be doing. I think Teferi is also okay. Okay, solid hand. Actually, I have all the that mana. I can't cast my Static Caster yet. You guys are just seeing everything that's wrong with the deck this league. I think it's okay to just play Caryatid here. The only way I get punished is if they have the double Emissary Nykthos Planeswalker draw. Like, even if they go Jadelight one turn earlier, it's... it doesn't feel great that I let them play Jadelight, but... it's, I think it's worth it. Alright, so they kept Burning Tree Emissary on top. Interesting. So that's bad for me. That means they have Nykthos. They're gonna go nuts next turn. I mean, they kept Burning Tree, so they probably have Nykthos. If they have Nykthos, killing an elf is just the same thing as killing a Jadelight Ranger. So I guess what I'll do is... just play Temple Garden and say go. And probably just Abrupt Decay the Jadelight Ranger. They don't have Nykthos, I'm gonna look like an idiot, but I don't think there's ever a reason to keep Burning Tree here if you don't have Nykthos. Makes very little sense to me. When they get a Gear Hulk. wonder what other content creator do. Do they just like restart the league when they're like 0-2 or 0-3, or do they keep going? I'm not sure. I think the games have been kind of interesting and close, and we got to play against a new archetype. We got to play against the one of the best decks, if not the best deck in the format. Got to see everything that can go wrong with Niv. Obviously, it's a really good deck, but you are playing five colors. I think the mana is good. I think it's just like all the freak scenarios that are happening. I mean, you've got the trophy leader who's playing Niv, so it can't be all that bad. Basic planes, yes, please. Please, basic planes. I wish I had the Karsten brain. Figure out what are the odds of your first six land all being abs and combination. It's gotta be like literally under 1%. Obviously you add up all the little things that can go wrong, and you know, it is more than 1%, but maybe Static Caster is a bit narrow. Maybe could have been like Teferi, Oath of Kaya. I think it makes sense to have it on the play. Maybe it's a bit too gimmicky though. I could see that, because it really only kills elves. This card's been pretty good to me though. I might have some kind of bias. All right. Up to chump. All right, so Solar Blaze keeps me alive. So Bring to Light keeps me alive. Never mind, they have Hydra. All right, I can't Blaze anymore. All right, that's probably GG then. Fail push, all right. Well, how's everyone doing? How's everyone's week going? Of course, if you like the content, if you love to see me lose over and over again, you can support us by shopping at channelfireball.com. We got singles, we got seal product, we also buy your cards. They have something that's called You Box It, We Buy It. You just send your cards in a box, you fill up a form that's just a few basic questions, and they sort the cards for you, they prize them, they send you back an offer. If you like the offer, great, you get to keep the, you know, you just proceed with the transaction. If you don't like the Channel Fireball price offer, you can decline and they will send you back your cards free of charge. So you can find that info if, you know, it's called You Box It, We Buy It. Also, this video is gonna go up on a Saturday. I think this weekend there's like the Commander Fest online going on. I think it's free to participate. Was, you know, you can donate. I think the donations go to a charity, but it is free to play. But you know, obviously. You can check that out on the website as well. And if you haven't done so, you can subscribe to the YouTube channel. You can check out Channel Fireball for more videos and articles. They also have CFB Pro now. That's the premium content part of the site. It was mostly deck guides, deck articles, sideboard guides, all that stuff written by Luis, Huey, Manguchi, Reed, all the best, you know, all the best players in the world, or some of the best players in the world. All right, can we get ourselves a win? This hand looks pretty great, not gonna lie. Hopefully we're not playing against Burn here, just shocking myself on turn one. All right. Garruk Harbinger. I cannot be discarded right now. I was gonna take that. The card's pretty scary given my hand. So looks like just straight up red green, probably company deck, if I had to guess. Don't care too much about War Boss. They get the one token, but then we can kill it. The Harbinger has Hexproof from black, and unless he does have Chum Blockers right now. Plan on playing this deck this weekend on Sunday in the Pioneer Challenge, so I'll report how I do in my next video. Not sure what I'm gonna play next week. Let's see, they don't have much going on, neither do I. So I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of the token. All right. I got scooped. It's not like I knew what I had, but all right, push seems good. Oath seems good. Static caster could be good. Blaze seems great. Getting bored out Hour of Devastation. Seems like Solar Blaze is just going to be strictly better. Bored out Thoughtseize, going to board out most of the Teferi, Nahiris, and Slaughter Games. Alright, what do we have left? We have maybe Teferi, maybe Static Caster. When in doubt, I don't hate like one of each of the Planeswalker. Outer End's a bit expensive in this matchup. Seems kind of bad. It's possible I just sideboard out Teferi too often. The card's so versatile, always does something. It does feel a bit underwhelming against a bunch of 1/1s and stuff. Alright, this hand's good enough. Turn 2 carry it, turn 3 Solar Blaze, kind of what you want. Obviously, I could use a spell, but it's kind of. I think it's the hands you just have to. I mean, this one's fine. You keep much worse, but I think you kind of just have to keep some of these hands when you're playing. When you're playing Niv, and that's why I like the 60-card version a bit more. Just you get more. You get better opening hands on average. You get carried at turn two, obviously, way more, and you're also like less variance past your draw step, you know. When you have a deck that's smaller, you just have less a smaller chance to just draw like three lands in a row when you kept a land heavy hand, or you know, if you need to draw a land, you're more likely to draw it, etc. So just less variance, which is nice. I didn't realize it's Travel Master this time, not the War Boss. Solar Blaze. Oh, I guess they're Winota. I didn't realize. They're splashing white. It probably means they're Winota deck and they have the token. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, I should have brought in Gravedigger's Cage. I don't think I saw White Mana game one. Maybe I did. Maybe I was just out of it. Let's see. I actually have weird mana here. I have to tap my Caryatid. Let's see. Yeah, I guess he does go Teferi plus because of Winota. Also, they probably have some few haste creature, just nothing to minus really. Pretty straightforward Teferi plus. I only played against Winota matchup once. It was in the tournament. And I won, but it fell close. Also, they didn't have like their nutty draws. So I made it a bit easier. That's nice. What should I do? I kind of want to Solar Blaze anyways first. I get Talsimir, Pian Kiran, bounce a token. Bouncing Talsimir doesn't... I guess I should play Solar Blaze first. I'm just going to go ahead and play, use my Solar Blaze and plus the Fairy again. I'm not in a rush. Alright, I should have played Steam Vent Stab then, probably. Is that a sneaky carried it on tap, actually? It's better against Warboss and Rival Master. I mean, we know that alone is definitely not scary. Alright, we got our first match win. Convincing, should I say? So I've been playing mostly Historic lately. We have a big tournament coming up and the format's gonna be Historic, so that's Arena, but I've been liking this deck in Pioneer. And in Modern, I've been not super happy with anything. I played the Soul Sister deck some more. I decided to see if my 14-1 record in leagues could translate to success in the prelim tournaments, and I did pretty poorly. I went 2-3, and the only two matches I won were... Oh, I kept that hand. I guess it's okay. Steam Vents go. It could be the Jeskai Luka deck. What else plays Steam Vent? I'm gonna assume just Jeskai Luka. I don't wanna play... I'm still gonna play Overrun Tomb on turn one. I can always play Triumph on turn two if... I'm gonna leave myself the option to abruptly key something on two, yeah. Either playing Team or Reclamation, All right, that's cool. That's the new deck in Pioneer. Not super surprising, I guess, that Team of Reclamation would be good in Pioneer. So yeah, I haven't played this matchup yet. I'm assuming it's tough. They don't have land. I think they play Sensors in their deck. I kind of want to lead with Uro. If they had Sensor, though, they would have... Alright, and I drew a second to fair. I was going to say if they had Sensor, they would have cycled it on turn one if their mana screwed. Unless they're playing the deck weird, but I think you should always cycle Sensor on turn one there if you don't have the lands. That being said, I just got Sensored. I think... maybe they just drew it, I guess. It's possible they just drew it up the two draw steps. If I hadn't drawn the second Teferi... I'm honestly not sure what I might have just jammed a Teferi for the reasons I was mentioning. That it didn't make a ton of sense for me for them to have... Alright, a bit lucky to have two of my three Teferi in this matchup. I'd have Dispute in the main deck too, okay. Well, looks like it might not matter, because the rest of my hand's freaking terrible. Or does it just stay mana screwed forever? That could work. Just gonna go ahead and get Ura mana. Gonna go ahead and play the Nahiri. Pretty good draw. Keep black mana up for Thoughtseizer, Defrychon, I guess. I'm gonna go ahead and discard the hour first. Alright, I guess I should have kept Overrun to untap. I don't think I want to get a land anyways. It's kind of close. Actually, I probably would have gotten a land. Yeah. Alright. Well, I guess it's my opponent's turn to not have the greatest draws. So this does something against Expansion Explosion plus Wreck. So maybe. And they're in Ura deck.
I think I have Shark, Typhoon, and Ura.
So I think Abrupt Decay is just better than Dreadwar in this matchup. Actually, Feral Push is good too. Well, good. Alright, definitely don't want the sweepers. Or Tall Simir. Or Oath of Gaia. Or Dreadbore. Or Fatal Push. Alright, so I get to keep one of these cards. Shark, Typhoon, Uro, Reclamation. Shark, Typhoon, Uro, Reclamation. Is Fatal Push just my best card? It might be. Wait, what? Why do I have 61? Was that just 60? Am I just losing my mind? Oh, it looks like I'm alright. 61 card special. No problem. Fail push. Damn it. Alright, it's not a bad hand, but if they have a good draw, they can obviously blow me out pretty easily. Here's kind of nice, getting rid of Reclamation. Could come in handy. And I think with Slaughter Games, probably want to name maybe Reclamation if they don't have Reclamation in play yet, and Expansion Explosion if they do. Maybe sometimes Uro. Speaking of the devil. Might have Aether Gust in their sideboard though, so it might not be like totally uncounterable. As uncounterable as I would like it to be. Alright, looks like that's the Aether Gust. Sensor. Alright. Can live with that. So now I have Land Reclamation. They can Explosion for 4 already. Rough. Alright, so they don't have Reclamation, or pretty unlikely. If I Slaughter Games, they can actually copy it and Slaughter Games me right back. It's kind of funny. Huh. I think that's fine though. I think I can win with no nibs in my deck. Because Expansion Explosion is, I think, yeah, it's a spell that costs 4 or less. Because you can copy canisters insides and factor fiction. Yep. It's fine. It's actually sick if they have 2, they can like resolve one, see what I have, and do it again. Maybe I'm still gonna name Expansion Explosion. And then game's probably pretty hard for them. Could name Uro, actually. They went with Niv, but I wonder if they're not just supposed to name Uro. What about me? Am I supposed to name Uro? I do have Otterheim and Abrupt Decay and in the here, so I have ways to deal with it, but I think I'm still going to name Expansion Explosion. I don't know, it's tough. Because they shouldn't have another one in hand, or else they would just play it on Nahiri. I'm just still gonna name Expansion Explosion. Is it really just Expansion? Oh, they just have two lands. Alright, so they have four Shark Typhoons and two Uro left in their deck. Pulled from Tomorrow, bunch of Negates. Aether Gust. All right, ended your breeding pool. Nice. They have two lands in hand, okay. Pretty happy to make my land drop here. Actually, that was bad. I should just play Fabled Passage, fetch, and then I can just shock myself next turn if I need to. Alright, did they really just drop Breeding Pool, Breeding Pool? Oh. Well, I'm glad I won a few, but also I feel like these wins were like way less interesting than the losses. And you learn a bit more from losses, so... And this one, I can just keep playing lands. Play my Uro, because why not? So we know what they drew. I'll go ahead and cue that. So no more Niv in my deck. I can get Nicobolas. I can just keep cycling too. Nicobolas. I'm not even sure exactly what all he does. It seems fun. Draw 2, 10 damage, creating put the creature. Alright, so it's gonna be draw 2 cards. Alright, well, Slaughter Games. They can copy it. Can copy it, they can gust it, but it is pretty effective against them. And yours still gets to resolve. But yeah, honestly, 5 match sample is pretty low. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I think even though I didn't win a ton, I still think the deck is really good. I still believe I have a favorable green matchup, but it was I did the playtesting session against Harry, it felt good. I was winning and it felt good, and he was drawing okay, but you know, obviously I should reevaluate after these matches, even though I do feel like my draws were pretty mediocre and their draw were over average, so still like the list. If prowess becomes a thing in the format, that could be scary. Maybe more disputes, having your own disputes to fight their disputes. Maybe my sideboarding wasn't super on point. I think I probably boarded out Teferi and stuff. When at the end of the day, they don't have that many creatures. Maybe they even trim a few one drops. Maybe make sure you have all your answers to the sprite and the entity and something for Treasure Cruise. I'm not sure what you can really do about Treasure Cruise, though. Or Graveyard Hate. Do I not have Gravedigger's Cage in my sideboard? Am I crazy? 13 card. Where did the rest go? Ah, yes. Classic. I like to reorganize in one pile, and I guess sometimes stuff gets lost. But yeah. Make sure you give us a follow or subscribe to the YouTube channel. And it was Gabriel Nassif for ChannelFireball.com. Hope you enjoyed it. Take care, and I'll see you next time.